Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. Today I will show you how to create floating text button in Android Studio and use it in our Android application. So this is the final product look like. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, you have to create a project in Android Studio. So I have a blank project over here. Now you have to go to the website that I have given link below this video. And in the website you can see something like this, and first of all here is a preview how it look like when we completed doing the thing. So we have a view which is almost look like something, a structured floating action button, and we have a image view over here and a text view. So all we have to do is simply copy the dependency. Now we have to copy the Maven jetpack URL and we have to add it in the project level Gradle file. So you have to add it below this jsender, and once that done you have to close that and now go to the second one, which is module app project level Gradle file. Now we have to come down and select the second one, which is a compile dependency, and we have to paste it between this dependency curly braces. So I'm pasting it over here. Now finally you have to click on the sync now. So once the sync has been completed, you have to go to the website again, and now you have to copy the usage, which is going to be the code for the XML file, which is activity underscore main.xml. Now go to the text. Now in the activity, you have to paste it between these two relative layout tags, and if you're having linear layout, you can also use it in any other kind of layouts. So once it is done, you have to simply change the things. I'm going to bring the floating text button into the center, so I'm typing Android center horizontal, that is true, and again Android center vertical, and that is true. Okay, so now I have the floating text button at the center of the screen. Now we can see here is a four different kind of errors. So first of all we have to do is simply keep the mouse over the app and press Alt Enter. Now it's ready and we have a new line over here. Now what we have to do is simply give the color for the floating text button. The color is going to be something like, I'm going to give it as the color primary. So color primary. Now I'm going to add that icon from the drawable folder. So I have an icon in my drawable folder. Now I'm adding the text as the app name itself. So I'm typing app name, which is going to get the string app name. Now I have it. And finally, if you want, we can also change the text color from the white into black or blue or something like that. Okay, now it's black. I'm going to use the white itself. Okay, so once that done, if you want, you can able to get the special vector icon from the drawable. So all you have to do is right click on the drawable, now go to new, and you can find here is a vector asset, click on that, which contain a bundle of icons which are vector images. Now you can choose from hundreds of icons from here, and all these icons are vector, so the image quality will be stable. And also you can able to search for a specific icon. For example, I'm typing for money, and you can see there are three different kind of images for the money. Now that's it, you have to select that, click next and finish. That's all. Let's go to the main activity and see how we can able to declare the floating text button in the main activity. So I'm going to the main activity. Okay, so let's type floating. Now let's add a one click listener, floating text button dot set one click listener. So everything is same as how we have done in the button. I'm going to make a simple toast when the floating text button is clicked. So hello. So I hope you guys got the idea, and if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Yeah, that's it. So all the links will be below this video, you can check that out. And if you have any trouble while adding this floating text button into your Android app, comment below this video and I will be happy to get you the answers. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.